Yes, so the topic that we have chosen for today is one of the primary topics of data engineering, that aspiring to be a data engineer. So what is data engineering all about? Let me just touch upon that, and then I'm coming to your topic for today. Right. So when I am talking about data engineering as a specialization field for computer engineering, right? So what is data engineering basically about? So data engineering is basically about, okay, so we have visited Amazon so many number of times, right? And when I'm visiting Amazon, what is happening is now say any student of my class out here who wishes to buy a t-shirt for him. Right, and who wishes to buy a t-shirt for him, say a red color t-shirt. Okay, so if I want to buy a red color t-shirt, what do we do at the start? We give a filter out there, right? So the color has to be red, right? And if I've got more specification to it, as in if I say that I want to have a red color t-shirt but then a round neck t-shirt, so what am I going to give? I'm going to give one more filter to it, saying that the style of my collar should be round. Okay, so these are the two filters that I have already applied to my Amazon.in GUI. What is happening after that? Uske baad kya hota hai? Ek baar jab aap filter apply kar dete ho, to aapko, you will have a visualization of all the red color t-shirts, right? Possibly of round neck. Yes, so these are the possible things that are going to happen. But then, who is going to provide me all these data? Right, so my machine learning engineer is going to sit there. I'm going to write beautiful algorithms to get to train my system and to get me the required data. But what is happening behind with the database, right? So when I say red color t-shirt, when I say round neck t-shirts, ye sara data prepare kon kar raha hai mere liye? Wo data engineer prepare kar raha hai. Right, so it is not only about databases, it is about structuring your data in a very well format so that it is directly used by the data scientist for getting insights into the data, is the job of a data engineer. Am I clear with data engineering? What do I want to say? So data engineering is a background work, right? Background work, but then a skilled work which is in very, very high demand now. Right. So more than a machine learning engineer, we need data engineers who can process the data well, who can give me a structured data well. Now, say suppose I'm speaking something right now. That's an audio file, right? Provided this is a video file, like, because you can see me as well. But then say suppose you have an audio file of say 30 seconds. Now you have an audio file. What is audio text? What is audio data? Audio data is a frequency data. Right. So when I want to analyze that audio data, is it possible for me to do it directly? No, it is not possible for me to do it directly. How am I going to do it? I'm going to get it in a structured manner. So what do I mean by a structured data and an unstructured data? Jo bhi aapka audio data hai, image data hai, video data hai, these are all unstructured data. And what do I mean by structured data then? Structured data is anything that I have in a tabular format. Okay, jo bhi data mere table format mein hoga wo structured hoga, jo bhi data mere random format mein hoga wo unstructured hoga, right? So my data engineer is going to give me the data in a structured format in that case. Okay, so this is all about data engineering and much more to it. So in layman terms, this is the best example that I can give it to you when I wish to explain data engineering to my aspirants, to my engineering aspirants who wish to pursue their career into specialization fields of computer engineering. Okay, and now let me just go to my presentation and come back to my topic. Do you have any doubts related to data engineering? You may ask if you have got any doubts related to data engineering students. You can ask koi bhi doubt hai aapka, otherwise we proceed with the topic. And yes, allow me a minute to get me with the presentation out here. And I hope the presentation is visible. Can somebody respond quickly if that's visible? Okay, is the presentation visible? Okay, nice. Yes, so when I'm picking up the topic, as I have picked up a topic of data cleaning, right? Very, very important topic as far as my data is concerned, right? So students, when I talk about data, and I like to pick up this example very quickly out here, and let me just put up something for you. So if I have got age of a student, right? I have got the height of a student, right? And I've got the weight of a student, of a child basically, right? So age, height, and weight of a child, right? Can you give me some examples of ages? मैं एज वाले डेटा में क्या डालूं यहाँ पे? कैन यू गिव मी सम एग्जांपल्स, सम टू और थ्री एग्जांपल्स इन इयर्स, इन मंथ्स? कैसे लिखें इसको? हाउ डू वी राइट दिस? कैन आई गेट वन एग्जांपल फॉर इच? कैन आई राइट 10 इयर्स? इज इट? यस. कैन आई राइट 9.3 इयर्स? इज इट पॉसिबल? यस. ओके, कैन आई राइट 11 इयर्स, 13 इयर्स, 14.5 years, right? So this is the data type that is supported by age. Okay, can I also get height in centimeters if possible? So say the height is 105 centimeters, say the height is 107 centimeters, for example. So this could be 97 centimeters. So say the height is 110, it is 114, 140, and it could be 150, right? And now the weight, it is, now say for a 10-year-old, the weight would be 30, suppose 30.5. Now this could be 20, 27, 35. I will make this as 55.5, and this could be anywhere between 60.2. Right now, can somebody tell me what is the difference between the data type that I'm writing here? You all know numbers, right? You all know numbers very properly, right? So when you all know numbers out here, what is this data type out here? Ye integer hai ki decimal hai ki kya hai? At least mathematics ke basis pe. So this is decimal, this is integers, and this is decimal, right? Right. When I'm talking about data in terms of my, as say, taking my data engineering into consideration or picking up my data science into consideration, I divide my data into two categories, right? And I'll just come back to those two categories out here. And what are those two categories is that one is a discrete category, and one is a continuous variable, right? When I say a discrete variable, that means I've got some specific number of class size. So I've got a student of, there are 30 students in the class, there are 45 students in the class, there are 60 students in the class. So this is what we mean by discrete numbers, right? So 30, 45, 60, 1, 5, 75, 100, these are discrete numbers, discrete variables, right? But when I say 30.2, 55.5, 1.2, these are continuous variables, right? So there is an infinite range of numbers that are possible out here. So this has to be clear to you all, what is discrete variable and what is continuous variable in that case, okay? And there is one more category to writing my my values out here, and I am just going to put up the values here. Okay, give me a minute so that I put up the values here. And now again, I'm going to make a table here, and in that table, so student, gender, right, marks, and class as in the division, the rank that that person is scoring. So student name XYZ, the gender is a male, right? Marks that he has scored is 80.5, right? So he belongs to class 1, that is first category, right? So ABC is another student, a female, right? She has scored 82.3. And she also belongs to class 1. I've got another PQR, a male with a percent of 70.2. he deserves a second division, so on and so forth, right? अब ये और कैटेगरीज आ गई हैं, राइट? इन दिस केस माय स्टूडेंट नेम इज वेरी क्लियरली कम्स इनटू कैरेक्टर, सो आई एम नॉट बॉदर्ड अबाउट इट. नाउ सी दिस जेंडर, राइट? व्हाट आर द पॉसिबल केसेस? ईदर अ मेल और एल्स अ फीमेल, राइट? सो दीज आर द टू कैटेगरीज, राइट? सो दिस कम्स अंडर माय थर्ड टाइप ऑफ डेटा दैट इज पॉसिबल, दैट इज कैटेगोरिकल डेटा. So this is categorical data wherein I've got only two types, either male or female. Now, can somebody respond about marks? 80.5, 82.3, 70.2. ये कौन सा variable है? ये category तो है नहीं, because this is going to change like anything. So what is this? This is discrete or this is continuous? This is continuous. Okay. And how about class now? क्लास कॉन्टिन्यूस है कि कैटेगोरिकल है कि डिस्क्रीट है? कैन समबडी रिस्पॉन्ड? व्हाट इज क्लास? क्लास में क्या आएगा? या वन आएगा, या टू आएगा, या थ्री आएगा, या फोर आएगा, ज्यादा से ज्यादा, राइट? सो व्हाट इज इट? कैन समवन रिस्पॉन्ड? लेट लेट दिस क्लास बी इंटरैक्टिव एज पॉसिबल. कैन समबडी रिस्पॉन्ड? व्हाट हैज टू बी द क्लास देन इन दैट केस? व्हाट शुड बी क्लास? सो इन दैट केस माय क्लास हैज टू बी a categorical data, right? It has to be categorical, right? So what did we do till now? We understood what is discrete, we understood what is continuous. These are the two types of variables that are most common in my data sets. We also did something called as categorical, right? जिसमें कि आपके क्लासेस बनेंगे स्पेसिफिक वैल्यूज, राइट? सो दैट्स अबाउट कैटेगोरिकल, वेयर इन आई हैव गॉट जेंडर फॉर एग्जांपल, राइट, एज वन ऑफ द कैटेगरीज. आई हैव गॉट रैंक्स, 1, 2, 3 रैंक्स एज सेकेंड कैटेगरी. दीज आर जस्ट द एग्जांपल्स ऑफ रैंक्स. ओके, नाउ देयर इज वन मोर थिंग इन टू कैटेगोरिकल विच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर यू ऑल टू अंडरस्टैंड. So that we proceed in for the example. Okay, अभी और एक category होती है. एक होता है जिसमें आप उसको बोलोगे nominal, and there is one more. We call this as, one is nominal category and one is ordinal category. Okay, yes. So what comes under nominal? Under nominal comes my class as 1, 2, 3. That's nominal. Okay, under nominal comes my gender, classify as male or female. Under nominal comes my mobile mobile company type, iPhone hai, Android ki, Samsung hai ki, Apple hai ki, Samsung hai ki, Realme hai, what not, right? So that's my mobile company basically. What comes under ordinal? This is, ordinal is an ordered set, right? So when I say an ordered set, you all give feedbacks, right? You all give feedbacks. What do you write? Jaise usme hoga disagree, agree, strongly agree, right? Have you seen this categories? So either you put a tick on disagree, or you put a tick on agree, or you put a tick on strongly agree, right? So this is ordered. We start from the lowest till the highest, or we start from the highest till the lowest, right? So the ranks that I am providing here are in an ordered fashion. So this is ordered. I cannot say ki gender mein male or female ko main order karu, right? So male and female could be in any order, and so I say male and female. Okay, generally I pick up the example of flower category. I can put it up as rose, lotus, sunflower, right? I don't have a specific order to it. I just say that these are the flower categories. You put the data into these categories, right? But then when I have got an ordered set, that is called as ordinal. Disagree, agree, strongly agree, right? I hope this is clear to everyone. Is this clear? Can I get a response from the students if this is clear? Okay. Yes, okay. Thank you so much. And on this note, now I'll come to my cleaning value and what is data cleaning is all about, right? Now, again, I pick up an example of say any value out here. So I have got the product type, right? I have got the product sales. I have got the revenue generated by the product. And I've got this profit and loss. A random data pickup here, right? So product type is mobile phone. The sales is some X amount. So say the sales would be in number of pieces that I have sold. So say 10,000 pieces that I have sold. The revenue that is being generated is in lakhs or crores. So say 20 lakhs is the revenue that is generated. And the profit is say 1 lakh rupees. Right? Another category is say gadgets. Right? So the sale is suppose 20,000. The revenue that is generated is 30 lakhs, 30.5, whatever you want to write. The profit is suppose 50,000 rupees, right? The third category is clothing, right? Sale is 1 lakh is the sale, 1 lakh products that I have sold, 1 lakh. And revenue that is generated is in crores. And my profit is in... So I say it is 10,50,000 as the profit. Okay. Okay. So this is my data. Now you can pick up ki isme se discrete hai, ki continuous hai, ki categorical hai. So my product type is categorical. I have got some fixed types that are being given to me. So this data is categorical. Right? Now, second is sales. Now, this sales is a discrete number. This could be any number. Revenue is again a discrete number or a continuous number. And profit is also a continuous number, right? Now, say suppose it happens that I am writing one more type out here. And that is suppose belonging to my home appliances. Right? And somehow I don't have the sales figure to it. Right? And I put up none here. Okay. The revenue is suppose revenue generated. One moment. Let me just admit the student. Okay. Now, say suppose the revenue that is generated out here is given. And I am getting some value here of 20 lakhs, right? And profit is somehow mistakenly not a number, right? I have given a negative number, suppose. The negative number is a loss, basically. So, ek ye null entry aaya hai, that is not a number, right? Now, what will happen? Appliances category is fine. Sales, I don't have the number. Revenue, I have a value to it, and profit is not a number, right? So my concern areas are this. The moment I don't get this data, I cannot do any analysis to my data because to a none, to a not a number, I cannot process it. I will have to get this data in the right format so that I can process it. This is what we mean in simple terms by data cleaning. I hope I'm clear on this. What is data cleaning all about? So the data cleaning is any missing value you have, you're going to fill it up. Any value that is not required for that particular column. Now I say that this is discrete data. Right. If it is discrete data, ideally there has to be numbers out here. But what is this none doing here then? Similarly, I'm saying that profit is again a continuous number. Then what is this NaN doing here, right? So I'll have to fill these values with some values. Got it? So that I can go in for the analysis. without filling up this, without correcting the data, I cannot giving to cannot give it to my data scientist, data analyst, machine learning engineer to process this data, because this is incomplete data in that case. Okay, now if this is clear, can we move ahead? Can I get a response? I hope you got the point. What is data cleaning all about now? Yes, did you get the point? What is data cleaning now? Okay, and if you got the point, what is data cleaning now? Let me just come to our important example for data cleaning, and for that I will be going in out here. Is this visible? Font size visible? Now is this visible? Oh, can I get a quick response if this is visible? Can you see my Jupyter notebook? Okay, the code basically. Yes, and if you can see the code, but we are not worried about the code here. We are just trying to understand how to fill up this missing values basically, right? And when I'm trying to fill up these missing values, students, I have created a small data set for you all, right? So that you understand this. Now, what is this data set all about? Now you can see here, it's a column data, right? Wherein at the first row, I have one, the second row, I have two, the third row, I have got a NaN. NaN stands for not a number, because maine data set mein kya diya hai? None diya hai, right? And my next value is 4, next value is 5, next value is 6. Can somebody respond what is the type of this data that I am giving up in the data set? What is the type of this data that I am giving up in the data set? 1, 2, 4, 5, 6. What is this type of data? This is discrete data. These are discrete variables, right? And in discrete variables, my all the values have to be discrete. What is this none doing here, right? So given a data set, your first task is to find out whether you have got missing values or no, right? This is a small data set that is given to you. Ideally, when you do real world examples, you have got a data set that has got lakhs and lakhs of records, right? So it is not possible for me to visualize the data and then come to a conclusion that, okay, so this particular row has got missing value, this particular row has got missing value. That doesn't work, right? So to make you understand, my first task is I just have a glance on my data. Now next is, this is this ILOC command. What is this ILOC 2 means? The index for my third row, this is 0. 0, index is 0, row is 1. Index is 1, row is 2, because I started from 0. Index is 2, row is 3. Now, index is 2, row is 3. I am getting the result as NaN. That is not a number. And I'm supposed to modify it. So what does NaN mean? NaN is not a number, right? And my all the data, other data is a number. So I'll have to put a number out here. But that, before doing that, how do you identify whether there are missing values in your data set? Is that, now please understand this, when I give pd dot is null, right, is null at my first index, so is null at my first index will return me a false, because is null is a boolean value. Boolean value matlab true or false mein result aayega. So agar main is null first index pe karu, to mujhe result kya aayega? False aayega, kyunki wo null value nahi hai. Agar main ILOC 0 dalu yahan pe, I will get a false, because my first index is also a number, so it is going to return me a false, because this is the correct data. Now if I give ILOC pd is null at 2, right, what will happen at 2? Because 2 is not a number, it is going to return me a true. That means I have got a null value here. Clear? Is this clear to everyone? So in a data set, when you run this is null, right? Now I run this is null on the whole data that I have on all the columns. And let us see what is it returning. What is it returning? It is going to return me where the actual values are and where I have gotten a null value. So where do I have a null value? I have a null value at 2, that is true, right? Ideally jab aap is null run karoge data pe, to aapko sara false aana chahiye. If all the values are false, that means you don't have any null value. If at all you have got any one true or more than one true, that means those particular rows have got null values, right? So is null is the command to give to your data to identify whether there are null values or not, right? So possibly if I insert one more null value here, now say suppose I give one more none here, okay? And so I've got two NaNs out here. Now let us just not run this and let me just come back to this. What will happen? I will get, it will return me two true values because there are two NaNs, right? So there are two true values at row number, at index number 2 and at index number 5. Let us make everything as a number. So now say this is 3 and this is 6. Right? And now I'm running this is null data. What will happen? Everything will be false. This means that your data set does not have any null values. Right? So this is one more good example. So now I'll put this as my original data set and we will try to solve it. Right? I hope this is clear to everyone. Is this clear to everyone? Is this clear? Can I get a response? Okay, nice, superb. Yes, and if this is clear to everyone, let me just go back and we will start. Yes, so is null is clear? Yes. So what am I going to do with this is null, right? Is null and is NA. Data.isNA is one more method of doing this. Idhar maine kaise diya? PD.isNull and data. Data.isNA is also one more method of doing this. You will get the same output. That's the Boolean output. Wherever you have got a null value, you will get that as true. Rest everywhere, you will get as false. Okay. Now, is NA is when I'm keeping it blank. So what will happen, students, when I add up all these columns out here? When I add up all these columns out here, that is data.isNA.sum, I am getting the sum as 1. Why? Because I've got one value as true, right? Ideally, what this should return? This should return me a 0. Sum has to be 0. If sum is 0, that means you don't have any value as a null value, right? If you've got a 1, that means there is one value that is a null value, right? Right, so let us just see if I put up one more value as none here, right? And now I'm going to run your is now sum. Now I've got 2 because how many values I've got null? 2 values, right? So you've got 3, then the sum would be 3. So you will understand that a total how many rows has got a null value. Clear? Yes, so this is one more in one more type how I can give how I can detect my missing values basically, right? So as of now, I've got my sum as 1. Your sum has to be 0. If there is no null value, your isNull.sum will give you a 0, right? Now, this is going to give me the percentage of my missing values in my whole data set. So isNull.sum divided by the total rows in my data multiplied by 100 gives me the percentage of missing values. So 16.66% is the missing values out here. Now, what have we done? We have done this for a single column. Now we will see the same if I've got 2 columns, right? So I have made a data set that has got 2 columns, right? And what is that data set? That data set says that first is a city. So I'm writing the city names as A, C, D, E, F. Second is the sales in that particular city. So any marketing data out here. So the sales is possibly a discrete number out here. So in city, I have got one null value, a none value. And in sales, I have got one not a number value. Okay, so we will see how do we identify the missing values here. So I'm going to use for every column. So what am I giving here? I'm giving for city, find out my isNA, right? So for my city, if I'm finding out my isNA, it is going to return me one true value at row number 1, right? Similarly, if I find it out for the whole data set with all the columns, तो एक वैल्यू आपका ट्रू यहाँ पे आएगा क्योंकि वो सिटी के लिए है और एक वैल्यू आपका सेल्स के लिए आएगा ट्रू बिकॉज एक सेल्स में नॉट अ नंबर है, राइट, बाकी सब जगह आपका फॉल्स आएगा बिकॉज रेस्ट ऑफ द वैल्यूज आर ओके. यस, इफ आई डू एंड इज ना डॉट सम, क्या रिटर्न होना चाहिए? जीरो रिटर्न होना चाहिए, राइट. बट इसमें क्या रिटर्न होगा? वन रिटर्न होगा, सिटी के लिए वन रिटर्न होगा और सेल्स के लिए भी वन रिटर्न होगा, बिकॉज देर आर वन वन वैल्यूज इन एवरी कॉलम दैट आर नॉट अ नंबर एंड नल वैल्यूज, राइट. सो वट इज द परसेंटेज इन दैट केस? 16.6% इन सिटी एंड 16.6% इन सेल, बिकॉज वन वन वैल्यूज आर मिसिंग आउट हियर, राइट. एंड नाउ वी सी वॉट डू वी डू विद दिस. Now, the easiest thing to do is you drop that column, you drop that row where you have a not a number, right? So is na is to find out the missing value, drop na is to drop the rows that have got missing values, right? So kaun se rows hain aapke paas jo aapko drop karne honge? 1 and 5, right? So when I return my drop na, it will return me without the not a number value. So it has dropped 1 and it has dropped 5 completely. So I've got resultant 4 columns, 4 rows only. So that is my drop now basically, right? So I'm dropping the rows that are giving me the null values. But this is not the easiest way of doing it, because this could lose the data as well. So if I in a data set of 1 lakh, if I have got only 5 missing values in some rows, I can drop it because the data set is of lakh records. But in a data set, if I have got 5,000 to 6,000 rows wherein I've got null values, I cannot drop it directly because that could lose me the data. So in that case, what do? We fill up those values. So now we are going to see how do we fill up the missing values basically. ओके, मतलब ये जो नन वैल्यूज हैं इसको हम फिलअप करने का ट्राई करेंगे विद सम वैल्यूज. ओके, सो नाउ वी हैव क्रिएटेड अ डेटा सेट ऑफ 3 कॉलम्स. वन इज द सिटी, वन इज द सेल्स एंड वन इज द कैटेगरी. ओके, सो सिटी इज एनी ऑफ द सिटीज, सेल इज अ डिस्क्रीट वैल्यू, category is ABC category, right? So the sales for metro could be in A category, the sales for tier 2 city could be in B category, the sales for a rural area could be in C category. Okay, so this is just an example, right? Now we will see how many is na and what do we do with the filling of these null values, right? So I can see that there is NaN and none out here in my data set. So what are we trying to do, students, here is we are trying to fill it up. Okay, and for filling it up directly, I have got a command out here, right? And for the sales thing, if I'm trying to fill it up, I've got row index number 5 where I have a missing value. I'm going to fill it up with a 0. Okay, the easiest method, one method, is fill up the NA value with 0. So the command is only simple, fill na with 0. In bracket, 0 means I'm going to fill up the NA values with 0. Is na to identify the null values, fill na to fill it up. So fill na is 0 for me. Which column? Sales column, right? And I'm trying to make another column that is filled with zeros. Let us just see what happens here. Now, this is my original data till here, city, sales and category. At index number 5, I have got a number that is not a number. In my sales fill 0, I am filling it up with 0. Right? So what did I fill it up? Simplest is to fill up with 0. Got it? My next is, if I am not satisfied with a 0, because these are discrete values, okay? So discrete values as in for Bangalore, if it's 1, Mumbai, it's 2, then for third city, it is 3, for fourth city, it's 4, next is 5. So this is progressive, right? This is increase. So if this increase and I suddenly 0, that does not suffice my problem. So what am I going to do is, I'm going to fill it up with the average value. Fill na with the average value. This see here, this is fill na with the average value. Pehle humne kya kiya? Fill na with a 0 value. Now the second type is I'm going to do fill now with an average value. And how did I calculate the average? It is with the mean value. So the sales का जो भी mean आएगा आपका, जितना sales का column है, उस total का mean लेंगे हम, और जो हमारा not a number है, उसको हम उस mean से replace करेंगे. So we are going to replace it with that mean value. Okay? And now when I run this, you just see this. So sales row number 5, I have got an issue, right? So zeros में मैंने उसको zero से fill किया था. Average में मैं उसको 4.14, so that's the average sale for my sales column. So that is what I am filling this up. Still better, yes, still better than zero. Okay. Now my third method is, you would have seen this, and my third method is somewhere. Okay. So if what is my sales value? It is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then a gap. Then 6, 8. So 5 is the previous value to it. And 6 is the next value to it. So either I fill it up with the previous value or I fill it up with the next value. Matlab, ya to mera ye NaN 5 se replace ho, ya to mera ye NaN 6 se replace ho, right? So we call that as method ffill. So fill na, my method is ffill. And what is this going to do? Fill na method as ffill, with fill it up with the previous value. Okay, so previous value to NaN was 5. So now my new value to NaN will be 5 as well. Okay, you see this gap is filled up using the previous value. So I don't have a NaN in my resultant, right? And my next method is fill now with bfill method. Method is equal. These are predefined methods. So fill now with bfill method. What is bfill method going to do? If my previous method is 5, my next method, my next value is 6. So I'm going to fill my NaN with 6 in that case. Okay. Yes. So this is basically, how do we try to, fill up the missing values in that case. Got it. Yes. And now if I have got a category, right? So if I've got a category, so your category so this is about sales. So we learned 3 types. One is I'm going to fill it up with a zero. Next is I'm going to fill it up with the average value. The third is I'm going to fill it up with the before value or the after value, right? So these are the 3 methods of filling up the missing values, right? But that is for which case? That is for discrete cases. What happens to categorical data? Right? What happens to categorical data? Categorical matlab A, B, C are the categories. So these are nominal values, not ordinal values. I'm talking about nominal values. Nominal values, I hope you remember what are nominal values. So nominal variables are the variables wherein these are classes, but they don't have a specific order. Right? So that's A, B, C. So DF category ka hai, this column, I have got a null value here. Right, so missing value for a category is different than missing value for a discrete value. Right, so what is it? How am I going to fill up my category? My category is I'm going to fill it up through the mode. Right, so fill now category with the mode of that particular column. So mean, median, mode. Right, so mean is the average, median is the out of 5, you will get the median at 3, right? And the third one is mode. So now I am going to fill it up with the mode out here. So this is for the category. So just see what is the category return. So ye category, so I have got maximum A. So this is going to fill up with A. So that is all about your categorical data. How am I going to fill up my categorical data, right? So I hope this is clear to everyone. What did we discuss today? Is this clear? Can we just have a quick recap to what did we do? What did we do today? Can somebody respond very quickly? We have seen categorical data and which data? Can someone respond? We have seen categorical data and discrete data. Yes, Aniket Patil. Very good. And what else did we see? We saw what is data cleaning all about. Yes. We also saw what is missing values. How do I identify missing values? Can you post it on the group, on the chat box? How do I identify missing value? ISNA, yes, very nice. So ISNA is the command, how do I identify missing values basically, right? So what is the method to fill it up? How do I fill up the missing values? What is the command? FILNA. Okay, FILNA is the command to fill up the missing values. And how do we do it? We have got how many types of FILNA? Three. One is either I fill it up with a zero or else average. Yes, very nice. Or else, yes, above value or below value. But this I'm talking about which data? This FILNA works only for some specific data. What is that data? Discrete data. Yes, very nice. What happens to categorical data? I cannot use these methods to fill up the categorical data. So mode is one beautiful method to fill up the categorical data. Right, correct, absolutely correct. Yes, thank you for being so very attentive, Aniket. Yes, and do you have any doubts now? Do you have any doubts? So this is ideally how do we take data cleaning into consideration and then we process it, right? So if you have got any doubts other than this, you may ask